Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back again to my YouTube channel. Thank you very much for your love and support as always. I'm so grateful. If to those the first time you are coming across this channel and you are seeing my face for the first time, this is Agatha Progress channel and I come across your way every blessed day. In this channel, we bring the best of news to your doorpost through this channel. And in this channel, correction is highly needed. Thank you very much once again for always tuning in. I am so grateful. Now, here is the video of the day. I don't really know how you felt about this video, but your opinion is highly needed in the comment section. Now, let's go and watch the video too.
Hey, this is another interesting one because a lot has been going on. Too many things has been happening under our watch. What are these things that is happening? You can't detect it. I can't detect it. But with a very strong man who is known as Mazina the Kanu, he has been an eye-opener to a lot of people, and together with what is happening in Southeast. Some people might say, who is Mazina the Kanu? Mazina the Kanu is the confirmed leader of Biafra and IPOP, the founder of Eastern Security Network. I know a lot of people have been hearing ESN, ESN, ESN. Yeah, he is the brain behind it. We all recall that there is a lot of insecurity in the Southeast of Nigeria, though it happens all over Nigeria, and there is a lot of turn up from the governors in that particular region. And when it gets to the Southeast, the governor of the Southeast don't want to protect the people the way they wanted because of the fear of the unknown. I don't really know who they are afraid of and why they have been afraid. Is it that they have been threatened of their life or their responsibility? I don't really know. So the people of the Southeast cried unto their governor that they need protection against this kidnapping and Funani henchmen. And it was really a challenging moment. And Mazina the Kanu took it upon himself and he launched Insta Security Network to enable farmers, parents and children go back to farm and to their daily business because it has not really been an easy task in the Southeast of Nigeria. And finally, the governors of the Southeast stood up and said, no, we need our position, we need to protect our territory, and they went to open or establish another security network known as Ebube Agu. So now, according to a reliable source, the governors in the Southeast now need some of this security network established by Mazina the Kanu. But come to think of it, at first, I thought the governors of the East would have a one-on-one accord with Mazina the Kanu. They would have speak in one voice, but no. Rather, a lot has been going on. Oppression and every other thing has been taking place. And now they want some member of the Eastern Security Network to be their watchtower. Of which Mazina the Kanu is not getting it really tough. And I have a video here about Mazina the Kanu. You have to hear it from him. The Hussy Smart himself, he got to speak every word according to how it happens and according to how it took place in the Southeast, and how he has already been there to protect and to grant provision for Eastern Security Network because he was the launcher and the founder of that network. And yesterday I have a video as well when I made the point known how Mazina the Kanu said that the DSS are about to set the Eastern Security Network up in another attack, that the DSS, they are about to go and rob a bank, and they will say it's Eastern Security Network that is the victim of that circumstances, that they need the money to purchase some weapon. And along the line as well, Eastern Security Network or the IPOP media person, the person of Ima Power, has come to address the issue saying they have no intention to kill or kidnap anybody. Their work is to protect and to guide all Biafra properties and human as well. So here is the video. Watch and listen.
Do you know
to
what
the leader of Ebo Biafra.
Let me tell you where they plan or intend to get their recruits from. From Eastern Security Network. Some of them have now approached some people they thought are frontline commanders of Eastern Security Network. One state in particular, one idiot in particular, Hope Osadema, sent people to go and inquire in Imo State that they should get him the name of the commander of ESN in Imo State. That he intends to make him the commander of Ebubatoro in Imo State. Are you listening to me very carefully? These are the people that he wanted to kill a few weeks ago. These are the people that him and his funny friends are still hunting till today. He's looking for them. So, all this announcement they made in front of their Fulani masters in Owerri is basically to say we are going to divide ESN. We are going to tell you that money talks. We have the money, the security budget. We are going to buy you people over. Trying to go back to what Gowon said, that the best way to defeat this agitation is by spraying money everywhere. To their horror, shock, and surprise, the people they met somewhere in Imo State, ask Sadikin Fulani, who puts at them, he will tell you. The people ask them, why don't you go to the leadership of Eastern, go to IPOB leadership and ask them to come and do this thing for you? Why are you coming to us? To divide us? And the people told them, we are under oath, we cannot do it. We cannot do it. So they have nobody. It's to come and poach a structure that we have already on the ground. You know, Hope Osadema is a 419er, he's a thief. He used laptop to steal before. The Janjaweed are very clever. They decided to give us idiots as our, impose idiots and call them leaders. A 419er, a certified criminal, a hardened criminal, a highway robber. They claim is the governor of Imo State, sitting in the same office as Mbakwe. What an insult. What an insult to the memory of the great legend himself, Sam Nnamdi Mbakwe. He went to go and poach ESN officers. Listen, they were announcing we have a bag with nobody to show for it. After 2 days or 2 or 3 days, they went in search of ESN officers to give them money. We will give you everything you want. Come and become our head. Can you imagine such nonsense? As some will say, only in the East, only in Igbo land, only in Igbo land, only in Igbo land. Very, very sad indeed. That is where we are today. They want security outfit. The meeting resolved to maintain a joint security vigilante for the, which means in the Abubago, the commissioner of the Fulani Commission of Police in Imo State will be there. The Fulani AIG for maybe zone 9 or zone 8 or zone 15 will be there. These people are idiotic. They are so foolish. Can you imagine? So you don't know that if you have Fulani policemen and Fulani army officers in your so-called vigilante battle, they will tell their, when you want to go and attack them, they are the ones that will now inform their people that you're coming to attack their camp. You don't know that. I thought intellectualism. Is this your intelligence? The sum of all your this like this. You bring Fulani that is killing you. You bring their brother in the, there's a police commissioner. You put him in the committee that will be a part of this battle. And then you now go out to go and fight. Ask yourself, the same people you are bringing into your battle, they cannot even enforce grazing ban. Open grazing is against the law. Since 1968 in Nigeria, since 1968, open grazing by Fulani is against the law. Against the law. They cannot enforce it. Now you want them to come to become part of a group, vigilante, that will now stop their own people from grazing. Are you not foolish? Are you not foolish? Ndinzuzu, we must continue to preach this very gospel of heaven.
Oh my word, that is all about this video. Hope you do enjoy this video. Please, if you know you haven't subscribed to this wonderful channel, do well to subscribe, like, and share. Thank you very much for always tuning in. And if you watch the video to this very end, you are the best. See you again in my next post shortly. See you when I see you. Bye-bye.